I could do all that stuff. I just don't feel like it. That was me, honors pre-calc, a devilishly difficult class for my humanities wired brain. Lyndon B. Johnson's granddaughter was my teacher, actually, and toughness runs in the family. It was a hard high school class. Tests and quizzes were trouble enough, but I remember hating the homework sets most of all. Each Monday, we received a pile of problems to solve for the week. These weren't quick responses. From what I remember, these questions took hours to complete. Each moment struggling through polynomials and logs passed slowly, so slowly it was almost excruciating. And so I often skipped the assignments. I would turn in something, but I wouldn't give them the attention they deserved. I'd scrawl out half-baked answers on the bus. I'd pretend work them through lunch, and then I'd mind the back of the book for the answers. My pre-calc grades suffered thanks to poor habits. One day, my mother asked me about my struggles in math class, and I distinctly remember my answer. I could do all that work each week. I could be like my fellow grade A students. I just don't feel like it. And my mom, rarely the tough love type, snapped back at this one. "That's meaningless," she said. "You might as well say you could run a marathon if you felt like it. Saying you could do something is worthless. All you are is what you do." Years later, as I've begun dipping into philosophy, this idea returned. Jean-Paul Sartre tells the story of a French student in World War II who faces a dilemma: go fight in the war and leave his ailing mother, or stay with his ailing mother without contributing to the Allied cause. "Professor Sartre, what should I do?" Sartre responds, "The decision is fully yours. No one can decide for you, and it absolutely matters what you choose. We are the sum of our thoughts and actions, nothing more, nothing less." No could-haves, no would-haves. Saying you had the potential, had things just been a little bit different, reaches the same depth of pathetic as my math class claim. You have absolute freedom to take action or not. Hypotheticals don't count. So what will you choose? As Sartre said, the existentialists were seen as pessimists. But in his mind, people couldn't just stomach the sternness of their optimism. Choose well.